मौका दिया और मैंने अभी यहाँ पर बैठकर तमाम जिम्मेदारों की गुफ्तगू उनके तस्वीर अफरोज बयान को सुना। मैं ज़्यादा वक्त आपसे नहीं लेना चाहता, जो मुझे वक्त दिया गया है इंशाअल्लाह ताला उससे पहले मैं अपनी बात को खत्म कर दूँगा, क्योंकि फ्रेंड्स ने मैंने अभी जनाब से इजाज़त दी, उन्होंने मुझसे कहा कि आप अंग्रेजी में बोलिए, तो मैं अपनी बात को अंग्रेजी में रखना चाहूँगा और हज़रत हुकुम उस पर अमल करते हुए दिस टुडेज़ कॉन्फ्रेंस मेन एजेंडा इज़ एजुकेट एंड एजुकेट। एज़ ऑल ऑफ अस नो दैट द 2011 सेंसस has clearly said that the national literacy rate of our country is 73%. When it comes to Muslims, it is 68.5. And when it comes to Muslim women, it is lowest among all the females in India, that is 48.5%. Now this in itself is a huge cause of concern for not only the Muslims, but also for the whole country. Day in, day out, we hear that every political party, especially the secular parties, I don't know what secularism stands for, I'm still trying to find out the exact definition of secularism. I know what communism stands for, which is rightly represented in the face of our Prime Minister. Now all these political parties, their main focus is we want to empower Muslims. But when you see the data of 2011, which is an empirical evidence, which clearly shows that in our country, other religious, other social religious communities have progressed. But when it comes to the Muslim community, a deliberate attempt has been made to ensure that this community does not really move forward, does not really empower itself. Yes, I am the first one to say that we also have to take the responsibility. I am the first one to say that we also have to do some introspection. But having said that, it is the people in power, in whatever political form they are intellectually dishonest. And that is why we see that this, we are celebrating years of our independence. And how is it that our community has been deliberately kept back? Yes, there are some green shoots in the south of India, whether it is Telangana, whether it is Andhra Pradesh, whether it is Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Karnataka, yes. To a certain extent in Karnataka as well. But what pulls down the Muslim community is states like Uttar Pradesh, states like Bihar, states like Assam, states like West Bengal. And all of these states have been ruled by the so-called secular parties and the communal parties. In fact, you will be surprised to know, I'm sure all of there are many experts who are here who would agree with me that Uttar Pradesh has this great distinction. And in fact, I would say this honorable distinction that Muslim literacy rate has increased by 8-9% from 1-11 census. In Uttar Pradesh, it has gone down 2%. It has gone down 2%. Now, that is why I say that I am yet to find the definition of what secularism really stands for. And it is through these conferences that we should give a roadmap, if possible, a vision for especially states like UP, Bihar, West Bengal and Assam, that we will have to ensure that Muslim community from especially these four states in particular and also in Metro India, that how do we bring them up? How do we ensure that not only the literacy rates increase, but also the education standard increase? And all of us know that such a committee has rightly said that only out of 100, you find only 5 Muslim graduates. How do we improve that number? And to improve that number, it is very important that Sachar Committee, I think so, in my humble opinion, I feel that Sachar Committee is good for empirical evidence. But what we need focus more is on the Kullu Committee report. The Kullu Committee report, the recommendations of Kullu Committee report have been given to the present BJP government. And we will have to ensure that those summary recommendations which were given in October 2014 are implemented by this government. When I say this BJP government, I say this because Mr. Modi as the Prime Minister during the book release function in Delhi on 15 June 2016 has said that in Quran, word ilm has been used 800 times. That is true, but what is Mr. Modi doing? The problem with Mr. Modi and his government is that they only do lip service. Mr. Modi said Quran is, in the Quran word ilm has been used 800 times. He also said that I want to see a Muslim with Quran in one hand and computer in one hand. But the fact of the matter is, the reality in this country now is that instead of giving computer in our hand, Mr. Modi and his party is ensuring that we are killed in the name of power. We are killed in the name of Buffalo. We are killed in the name of nationalism. Where is the question now? This atmosphere which the present BJP government has created in this country is nothing but to ensure that Muslims are treated as second-class citizens of this country. We are not given our constitutional rights. The constitutional rights are equal, are given equal to everyone. What is the preamble of our constitution says? Fraternity, equality, justice, where is that? And yes, the blame lies also with the parties who have previously ruled this country. And that is why I say that this particular conference should give out the roadmap, should bring out the vision. I know that many documents have come out, but we will have to give a roadmap to the Muslim community that this is what we want to do. Secondly, we must protect two central industries which this present government wants to take away the minority character. Mr. Modi says word ilm has been used 800 times, but his government wants to take away the minority character of Aligarh and of Jami Millia Islam. Why do they want to take it? And please remember that not 100%, only 50% of students are Muslims in Aligarh. That is what his government wants to do. You can very well understand that what they say is complete farce. And just now our learned member has talked about Deen Dayal Upadhyaya. Who is Deen Dayal Upadhyaya? Deen Dayal Upadhyaya is the one who said that Aligarh Muslim University character should be finished. Deen Dayal Upadhyaya said Urdu should be finished. Deen Dayal Upadhyaya said Islam should be denied. Deen Dayal Upadhyaya said in his theory of critical humanism, he gave an example that if two Hindus come together, two Hindu buffoons, they are crooks, come together, they will think about country. But if two Muslims who are of unsocial character, they will never think about country. This is what Deen Dayal Upadhyaya said in his theory of critical humanism. And now we have this government proudly proclaiming as if Deen Dayal Upadhyaya is some paragon of virtue, is another Mother Teresa. Now we cannot accept this because the fact of the matter is there. Now coming back to my state of Telangana, where I come from, it has been rightly pointed out by Mr. A.K. Khan. Very clearly he has laid down what the present government has done. And I must say on record that what has been done by the government so far, in my last 23 years of political life, I have never seen a chief minister so concerned about Muslim religion. The chief minister, whenever we meet him, the last meeting we had, Mr. Khan was there. In that meeting we said, sir, that many issues are there to be addressed. The chief minister was very positive. Now, as rightly pointed out by Mr. Khan, that this government has established more than 200 residential schools, where more than 50,000 students are studying free of cost. From class 6, 7, 8, the standard of education is fantastic. And I am sure you please mark my words. If we meet here after 10 years, you will find a great revolution in Telangana that will come from those poor Muslim students, especially the girl students who are studying in these residential schools established by this government. 40 crore